Kelly, Ireland, 18 and 60, my dear, and loving son John. Your good friend, schoolmaster Pat McNamara, so blessed to write these words down. Your brothers have all gone to find work in England. The house is so empty and sad. The crop of potatoes is sorely affected. A third to a half of them bad. And your sister Bridget and Patrick O'Donnell are going to be married in June. Your mother says not to work on the railroad, be sure to come on home soon. Kilkelly, Ireland, 18 and 70, my dear, and loving son John. Hello to your missus and to your four children. May they grow healthy and strong. Michael has got in a wee bit of trouble. I suppose that he never will learn. Because of the dampness, there's no turf to speak of, and now we have nothing to burn. And Bridget is happy he named the child for her, although she had six of her own. You say you found work, but you don't say what kind, or when you'll be coming on home. Kilkelly, Ireland, 18 and 80, dear Michael and John, my sons. I'm sorry to give you the very sad news, but your dear old mother has gone. We buried her down at the church in Kilkelly. Your brothers and Bridget were there. You don't have to worry, she died very quickly. Remember her in your prayers. And it's good to hear that Michael's returning with money. He's sure to buy land. Crop has been poor and the people are selling for any price that they can. Kilkelly, Ireland, 18 and 90, my dear, and loving son John. I suppose I must be close on 80, it's 30 years since you've gone. Because of all of the money you sent me, I'm still living out on my own. Michael has built himself a fine house, and Bridget's daughters have grown. And thank you for sending your family picture. They're lovely young women and men. You say you might even come for a visit. What a joy to see you again. Kilkelly, Ireland, 18 and 92, my dear brother John. I'm sorry I didn't write sooner to tell you that father has gone. He was living with Bridget. She said he was cheerful and healthy right down to the end. Ah, you should have seen him play with the grandchildren of Pat McNamara, your friend. And we buried him alongside of Mother down at Kilkelly churchyard. He was a strong and a feisty old man, considering his life was so hard. And it's funny the way he kept talking about you. He called for you at the end. So why don't you think about coming to visit? We'd all love to see you again.